I hope I have answered the question. Yeah.
Sir, is it that we can go for Tikshnanasya Dharana and along with Prabhutamatra Snehapana only until the symptoms come down? Like rigidity of muscles in Akshepaka, you have said like that.
It is a treatment for Akshepaka. That rigidity is Akshepaka state. When Akshepaka state goes for till that, we have to do about 2 to 3 days. Then you go do Sneha Virechana, then Abhyang Vasya Chikitsa. Like that, you have to give treatment for 10 nights for Akshepaka Chikitsa. Then only you can go for Akshepaka.
Okay, sir, whether in between we can go for that Sneha Virechana?
Definitely. Once this Akshepaka goes, you can go for Sneha Virechana. Usually, I do you 7 or 8 masajigisas for about 2 to 3 days.
Sir.
Then the patient is relaxed completely. Then on 4th day onwards, start Mrudu Virechana and Anvasana and Astapana Chikitsa for about 10 days.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Yes.
Sir, next question is another question, sir, by Dr. Surekha of our department. Is pakshagata induced mukata in gliotic changes is reversible?
Madam, what is the question?
Pakshagata induced mukata. Mukata.
Okay. No.
In gliotic changes is reversible. It's a question, sir.
I think it has two parts. One
two
is
parts.
Mukata will occur in initial state itself. When there is a right-sided hemiparesis, usually there will be mukata. Yes. Vak will be there. In that state, if you give this treatment, the patient regains his speech. Definitely. But gliosis, that is the Akshaya state. There will be degeneration in brain. Let's say later stage happens. If it happens, Akshaya stage happens, definitely it is not possible to reverse.
Whereas in gliotic changes, is it an avarna, sir?
No, in gliotic it means it is Akshaya state. Akshaya state, you can, it is not avarna, it is Akshaya state. Akshaya state cannot be corrected. That's very difficult.
Sir.
Yeah.
So next question. By Dr. Amruta Kalaskar, Nasya is given by which drugs? Dravya changes according to condition like hemorrhage and blood coagulation.
Actually, ST paper vachamari tikku sainava kshira. I told all the slide is there. So, according to dosha, not according to coagulation and hemorrhage. We are giving treatment according to dosha. According to modern if the pitta stage is there, pitta pradhana avastha is there, the nasya is given by ST pippalikshi, vacha maritya vidurma tag. Okay, if kapha pradhana avastha is there, alpa sambandha is there, madha alpa sambandha tag is there, then we give ST pippali vacha maritya hindu sambandha. Okay, according to dosha involved, you select it. If more, then treatment of nasya is into tikshnanasya. That tikshnata is important, not drug. Tikshnata is important.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Audible.
Sir. Sorry for the inconvenience, sir. So the next question is how to prevent the repeated strokes.
Repeated strokes.
Recurrence of the.
Okay, understood. A very good question. If patient comes with this one, patient should not take nidana, same nidana, nidana parivartana. Number one, if a alcoholic, he should not take alcohol. If a tobacco smoker, tobacco chewing, he should not do it. Nidana parivartana is first thing. Second thing is that if you give Lashuna Rasonapinda, usually give Rasonapinda continuously, probably we can prevent recurrence of stroke. If it is not possible to get Rasonapinda continuously, you can give blood continuous like aspirin or Qutam. It is available anywhere in the world. It is available. We can take that out. Even after if patient takes the same nidana, definitely there is chance of recurrence that you can't prevent. Okay.
So after our management of Pakshaghata, can we give Rasonapinda as a Rasayana Chikitsa?
Definitely. You should give Rasonapinda. You give Rasonapinda as a even with that, if patient takes the same nidana, there is chance for recurrence.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Sir, the next question from our department is significance of Madhudaka, sir.
No, as a tarpana, definitely you can use Madhudaka or Narikela Jala. Usually, I give Shuddhi with the 40 ml Madhu with the sugar. I give usually to patients. So, as a tarpana, definitely it is useful. I think that is my
point. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, one of our participants named Kavya, they are asking to repeat the Vataja condition Nasya Dravya, sir.
Vataja
Pakshagata Nasya Dravyas.
Nasya Dravya is same. Shira.
Already
The thing is, in the Kevala Vachana, Vachana, Maricha, Hindu sign, without Kshira, we put in Nasya. I am telling only for the Akshepaka state, not Pakshagata state. It's Akshepaka state.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Avastika Chikitsa.
If stroke means, they will always be the Akshepaka.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, next question. Does our line of treatment differs based on origin of lesion, like in MCA territory and thalamic, sir?
No, we should not correlate with the modern medicine parameter. Here, how patient presents you, that's important. For us, at the time of Sushruta, there was no CT scanning or MRI scanning. But after this MRI scanning and CT scanning only, we are able to diagnose in CMC territory, is it peripheral, is it left canal, all these things. When we give Ayurveda treatment, I think this modern advancement is needed to diagnose the place and to prognosticate the disease. But for treatment, it should be based on dosha vikalpa. So when patient comes to you, how they presents you, in which state? Is it in Akshepaka, is it Pakshagata? If it is Akshepaka, is it Mitra Samanmaya, Kapha Samanmaya, or Kevala Vataja? That should be your deciding factor for a protocol, or for deciding the drug, not your modern diagnostication techniques. Modern diagnostication technique will help you to find Sthana Samshaya and some hetus. Is it Kruni? Is it Abhigata? Is it Dosha? These things will make up. Is it a growth? Yes. I hope I made it clear in my presentation, all these things.
Yes, sir.
I have discussed.
Sir, the last question, sir. The significance of Tikshna Vamana in Pakshagata.
Yeah, when in each state, you can use either Tikshna Vamana or Tikshna Nasya. But in Akshepa Kamastha, he has told only for Tikshna Nasya, not for Vamana. It's Vamana. Tikshna Vamana is told when there is a Murcha is there. And patient is in Murcha Vastha, Madha Vastha, then you can give this Tikshna Vamana. Tikshana, but the patient is an akshepaka, sir. We are treating akshepaka. For akshepa, he has told Suresh, work with Narayana Tikshanasya. Then Sarpipan said, there is no role for Omar in that state. But once the state is gone, you have given Mrutu Vivechana. Then if you want, you can give Omana Karma. But Omana is indicated in that state. But the question is having Murcha as a presentation. As Murcha, you can give Omana. Usually, patient comes with a meeting to you. Now, already, Omana happens. Many two, three times in the
yes, way. Already, patient presents with that condition, sir. Yes. Sir, can you explain few of the rasaushadhis in Pakshagata according to doshas, sir? Dosha vikalpa.
Here, this question is very good. First of all, I will tell about grita. Which grita you will give in the which dosha? If a kapha samadhana is there, he uses panchakarma grita as a grita pada. If it is kevala vata, prabhuta matra kalyanaka grita is given. If it is pitta, pitta dosha is pradhana, then I use mahapitta grita as a prabhuta matra nadravya because it contains amalakiswara. When Rasaushadhi comes, after that when Rasaushadhi, he usually used to either Samirapannagarasa or Mallasindura and Swarnasindura or Makaradvaja and Siddhamakaradvaja. So this does, usually in Kapha Samanaya state we give Samirapannagara and Mallasindura. But Pitta Samanaya is there, Pitta Pradhana is there, we use Swarna Sutashekara and Siddhamakaradvaja. This is what we usually, and as a Jwarahara Chikitsa, because if Madhamarcha Jaragna Dravya, we use Lakshminandrasa or Uttinji Rasa. These are the things we use. Especially Rasaushadhi is only the Dhammacharya use in initial state. And after that, Shilajitvikta drug is Chandra Prabhavati is given for Asya Rasayana. Okay, I think I have.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Is there any other question you can ask?
Sir, another question is limitations of Ayurveda, sir, in stroke management.
I think I have already answered in my presentation. Yes, the patient could not drink your aphromasia.
Yes, sir.
That is the limitation. And in the CT scanning itself, you see there is a midline shift.
Yes, sir.
Midline shift is there. Then I think that is a limitation. If midline shift is there, such cases usually they not able to drink it.
Yes.
Then I think you need some modern management. Sometimes right-sided hemiplegia, even a smoking person, they are able to drink. You can put the attitude, then you can manage it. Don't think you can't dilute, you can't do the iron. Then also you can give iron treatment. Only thing is, if patient develops some complications like aspiration pneumonia or severe convulsion, these are all happens. After Snehman also, there is a convulsion continuously happens. That is a limitation. You have to refer the case for advanced technology. There also, such patients will not survive. Because I have seen plenty of cases, they go to a modern center, they get treatment 10 to 15 days. Then they did not get any relief, they come to us afterwards. Then we give this protocol treatment, they recover afterwards. This also I have seen. They went to modern hospital, then come to us with the unconscious state. We give the treatment, then they recover. Such cases also I have seen. Plenty of cases it happens like that. Don't think that ours is sure treatment. There is a limitation is there. There is a avastha is there. Definitely you have to understand and you have to take help of modern diagnostic and treatment techniques. With that you have to treat. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, one more, sir. The treatment protocol for hemiparesis. Pakshavadha.
This still now you think it is akshepaka chikitsa, no? Yes, for pakshaghata. If a patient comes after 15 days, don't think all the patient comes in the initial state. They go to modern hospital, they are stabilized, then there is no akshepaka, they come with the pakshaghata state.
Yes.
Then what we have to do? I think this is your question, I think so.
Yes,
so,
sir.
This is a very important thing. Always, most of Ayurvedic doctors will not get any case in acute state. They get cases in after about 15 days or month. Then what we have to do? When so patient comes to you examine him properly. Patient comes with the anti-convulsant drugs. The conversion is forcibly subsided. Still, the patient may have rigid muscles. That indicates there is akshepaka. Then you have to go for the same akshepaka chikitsa. Tushnasyas, neyapana, all these things. If there is no rigid muscle, it is flaccid. It's a pakshaghata. Then pakshaghata chikitsa. There is a pitta symptom is there. You go for himadhara and tikshnanasya. And after that, and if this only flaccid muscle, then you go for according to dosha. If kapha dosha pradana, takradana first, and tadaila bhyanga, and basti karma. Basti karma will be mahamanishtadi kashaya basti. For anuvasana, brasaindavetaila basti. For sneha virechana, erandataila with gomutra. These things we give. If patient is a pitta pradana, is there. Patient has hypertension, that means patient may, because of antihypertensive, is suppressed. Then we go for Mahatiktagagrita, or patient may have hemorrhagic this one. Usually they produce pitta symptoms. Go for Mahatiktagagrita for Snehapana and Eranatayala with Gokshira, and for Basti Mahamandishtadi with Kshira Kashaya Basti. Like that we give, and Abhyanga for Kshirabala Taila, and Dhara with the Kshirabala Taila Dhara, like that we give for about 15 days treatment. Like that, according to dosha, we have to treat. Only Nasya if needed, that state also. If needed, you give Nasya Karma first for 3-4 days, then Mrudu Virechana, then Basti. Only thing is, no need of giving Snehapana in that state. If patient comes in Pakshaghata state, you can give same nasya as pakshaghatara nasya. No need of giving snehapana. Snehapana for akshepana. No need. Then you go for mrudu virechana and bastikarma. I hope you have answered the question. Yeah. Muted. You have muted your mic.
Sorry, sir.
I can't hear.
Sorry, sir. The next question is, role of Rakta Mokshana in Pakshaghata.
Yeah. In Rakta Mokshana Adhyaya, he has contraindicated two conditions for Rakta Mokshana. Even if it is a condition, another condition is Bhagna. These two conditions social and contraindicated. Even though it is Raktavana, Bhagna also Raktavana. In these two, Mokshagata and Bhagna, Raktha Mokshana is contraindicated. You should not do Raktha Mokshana.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Now, I request our HOD to give vote of thanks, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pranam.
Namaste.
It's very great privilege for us to have a wonderful session and to fruitful session with you. And we are extremely apologizing for the network issues.
It's okay, it's okay.
And it's my great privilege to say what a thanks. The personality like you, I am also one of your students, sir. I'm very, very happy to say that I'm your student, like Dronacharya. You are like a Dronacharya, I'm like a fellow. I learned a lot of things from your practice. Yeah, many of my students, they expressed your line of treatment, and I have also tried, and I got succeeded also, sir. Honorable dignitaries and valued guests, It's my privilege to propose vote of thanks on behalf of this esteemed institution.